are like a seed. We become what we contain. Every single thing we see started planted in our brains. And our thoughts are like the rain. And our moods are like the sun's rays feeding our fate until our roots begin to take. And our sprouts begin to shape. And the tree of life escapes, branching out in love or hate to destroy or to create. I have never written a piece about peace. From the conflicts in the Middle East, I've watched the violence re-repeat, but who am I to comment on your grief when I haven't known the depths of your experience or your beliefs? It's easy when I say to turn the cheek, because all I have to do is speak, and talk is cheap. It's harder when you've had to watch your back while walking down the streets, and once you've been attacked, you'd see a threat in everyone you meet. You break a sweat, and your ears can hear your hearts beat, beat. No matter what side you're on, the history is deep, and yet we pray to different gods to get the very same relief. So at the risk of coming off like I'm trying to preach, I thought that I should offer my perspective at the very least. Everywhere's a temple. Everywhere's a church. Everywhere's a mosque. Just show me where it hurts. Everywhere is sacred, so anywhere can work. Because when aliens arrive, we'll be human beings first. We are human beings first. Beyond the boundaries in the dirt. So how we treat each other should be how we measure our worth. And finding peace is not an external search. Forgiveness is a choice. And it's both for those who've gotten hurt and those that did the dirt. I'm holding on to chains and complaining how my hands are locks. Open up my palms and watch the weight I used to carry drop. All the hatred has to stop. Our universe is infinite and we're a tiny dot. Imagine space through the perspective of an astronaut. We're chasing after God. Just be still and you'll discover He is in your heart. Every person you encounter is a work of art. You want to change the world, change yourself and it will start. Make a shift, and everything around you takes part or gets taken apart. Mother Nature can be ugly, and Father Time is endless. My enemy is a mirror if I'm willing to be fearless. I could be holding the gun that's pointing at myself. I could be dropping the bomb that's landing on my house. And I'm not saying don't protect yourself. Protect yourself. But know that revenge is against yourself. Identity is just a temporary shell. My unconscious mind perpetuates my hell beyond the circumstances themselves. And I don't claim to understand the circumstances themselves, but what I know is once we're here, we have to play the hands that we've been dealt. It doesn't help me blaming someone else or feeling sorry for myself or using God as an excuse to kill at will because He's on my side, like God would choose a side against another side when He is every side. I don't argue from a point. Karma is a circle, right? If it wasn't self-defense, then it was my internal fight. As above, so below. Holding space is the most important way for giving other people room to grow. Watch what I assume to know. Take it in, but don't take it on, or I'll respond by taking people personal. Tell my truth and let it go. By letting go of truth, I never know how someone else's truth can then affect my soul. Because once the conflict is started, we forget the goal. Hate is handed down through generations and it takes its toll. Every nation, every community has a consciousness and every individual plays their role. We either memorize the lines or we break the mold. We're either in a stage or on a stage. So we should question every single thing we're told. If we took all the energy we spent on waging war and put it into solving our disputes instead of making more, then maybe we could fix the problems that we think we're fighting for, and soldiers wouldn't have to live and die in a revolving door. What are they falling for? What am I standing for? We should turn the buildings that are bombed into dance floors. Our greatest pain can be our greatest celebration, but I promise it's in vain unless it brings a transformation. There's nothing that can bridge our separation like creation. As above, so below. Holding space is the most important way for giving other people room to grow. Watch what I assume to know. Take it in, but don't take it on, or I'll respond by taking people personal. Tell my truth and let it go. By letting go of truth, I never know how someone else's truth can then affect my soul. Because once the conflict is started, I forget to go, yeah, I know. I'm just a part in a greater whole. And everything I'll ever love disintegrates to dust. So I'm the only one I'll have to learn to trust. Finding peace without war would be hard enough. It's not us versus them. It's not us versus us. It's just us. Thank you.
Please welcome to the stage from Santa Monica, California, NQ.
You guys feel good, say yeah. If you're alive, say yeah.
I wanna entertain and inspire and challenge my audience.
You have a voice. Does it haunt you in the dead of night? Would you fly if you weren't convinced that you were afraid of heights? And who convinced you anyway? They had no fucking rights.
Hearty and hefty laughs.
I was coming out of my new therapist's office the other day, and sitting in the waiting room was my old therapist.
I feel like we can move the world in any direction that we want to.
Once you make your minds up, you can accomplish anything, even if it seems impossible. Impossible is possible. Intend what you desire, and your will be unstoppable.
Real, raw, juicy poetry.
I look at my Instagram page, and I wish I had my life. It's your authentic voice. And no matter where you go in life, it never leaves. And that's God, no matter what religion you believe.
Mind-blowing.
Inspired. Very inspired.
NQ is a beast!
Hey man, I am loving talking to you, but I also want to like go meditate. Whose fucking idea was this? You know what I mean? Spit it for the love again.
When I think of superheroes, I think of superhuman. I think of Superman, Wolverine, and Wonder Woman. Usually they have a cape or a mask to hide their face just in case. They have X-ray vision and superhuman strength. Some can even breathe in outer space. They fly around a while but always come back to keep our cities safe. They're here to save humanity from itself. It's a metaphor for how we look outside ourselves for help. And while the fantasies are fun, I choose to look to me and you. We don't need superheroes. We have superpowers too. It starts with being open to this moment. If you do, then you can own it. Besides, it'll be gone before you know it, so don't blow it. You owe it to this second of eternity to show up, embrace the possibilities and slow up. Take a breath and look around, see the sights and hear the sounds. Feel the ground, notice how the gravity holds you down. You could be anywhere in the world and yet you're here. When you accept that choice as your own, you can begin to overcome your fear. And real courage is looking in the mirror It's deciding what you want to do, then making that appear. It's innovating out of thin air. We must be doing something right if we get scared, otherwise we wouldn't care. It's a process to get here to there, there is no here or there, there's only here. We're on the journey and we're learning, but building muscle means you're gonna feel the burning. So don't deny it, simplify it, try it, see if it can work for you. Change perspective to get a different view. And don't forget, you gotta laugh at the truth. Because sometimes your sense of humor will be the only thing that can pull you through. It's medicine when you can let it in. An attitude of gratitude will bring a positive spin. So even when the storm clouds block the blue from your sky, you'll remember that the sun is waiting for you on the other side. And having fun is something we must decide. From the lows to the highs, it's all a part of the ride. I can throw my hands up. Everybody put your fucking hands up. Pretend like you're in a club and just shake it out. No, I mean really fucking shake it out. Or I can hold on for dear life. Hold on for dear life. But I'd rather live once than have to go to hell twice. Compassion is my passion, empathy is my gift. But my growth is incremental as my consciousness shifts. So I create from an abyss, turning pain into gold. I'm an alchemist, an optimist, and an authentic soul. I believe that life is good, even when it hurts to see. I believe in superpowers, and I believe in you and me. I believe in superheroes, but I don't look for them above, because they exist inside us all. And we save the day with love.